How many of you are pissed off from the Royal Rumble? Now listen, I'm not too pissed off about it, but I have some things that I'm gonna critique right now that WWE should not have done, WWE should have done. You know the story, no need of rehashing this part of it. Roman Reigns has won the 2015 Royal Rumble. He will main event WrestleMania for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship, and it looks like he will indeed face Brock Lesnar. We thought going into the Rumble, hey, is Cena gonna walk out the champ? Is Rollins gonna walk out the champ after cashing in? We didn't know who was gonna win this because the way that they had just put Rollins in this match, and I think I know why they put Rollins in this match. People said there's no way Brock's gonna walk out of here because why put Rollins in the match if Rollins was never gonna win or Rollins was never gonna cash in? It made Brock look stronger. It made Brock look like, hey, he has two guys in that ring beating the hell out of him, and he walked out of here. So Brock looks stronger as ever coming out of Mania, whereas Roman Reigns looks like the true underdog. And the way they set it up on Raw, which maybe it was a blessing in disguise with the snowstorm, but the studio show they had and the face-off between Brock and Roman Reigns with Paul Heyman at the end of Raw, it was brilliant. I think it made Roman Reigns look good. I think Heyman could make anybody look good. Brock with the stare down, it makes Roman look like the true underdog. And I think by the time Mania turns around, I think more people will be on the side of Roman Reigns. I mean, listen, it was a terrible night for WWE fans. I mean, Roman Reigns won the Royal Rumble and everyone was canceling their subscriptions. Or were they? WWE reached 1 million subscribers yesterday. So my thing was this: 80% of the people that were posting those pictures of cancel subscription, I think they were just copy and pasting what they saw on Twitter and they wanted to be a part of an angry fad. I mean, you're not canceling the WWE Network because why would you? Yeah, the product, you may not like the current product now, or it may not really tickle your fancy, but you got ECW pay-per-views in there, you got WCW pay-per-views in there, old WWE pay-per-views from the WWF days, the Attitude Era days. You got all these great original programming. You're not canceling the network. Plus, you got NXT, so stop. You're not canceling the network. It was a snow day yesterday for most of you around the country. You were probably watching the network yesterday. I know I was. WrestleMania 3 and 4, plus a couple episodes back of NXT I was watching. So you're not canceling the network. Cut it out. But I do have a few things with the Rumble. Number one, I would have liked to see an NXT person in there. While it was nostalgic that we saw DDP and Boogeyman and Bubba Ray in there, and I'm not complaining that they were in there. I know a lot of people were, oh God, they're 90 years old, what are they doing in the ring? Why are people like Zack Ryder in there? Why are people like Sin Cara in there? Why was Curtis Axel even put in to go down to the ring and not even make it in? I mean, a total waste of everybody's time there. Nobody cares about those three people. Nobody. I didn't know Sin Cara was on the damn roster. Curtis Axel is the biggest bust, I think, one of the biggest busts in wrestling history. And Zack Ryder, woo 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 your way out of our lives and just go away. But I thought they could have had Adrian Neville in there. I thought they could have put Sami Zayn, Kevin Steele, or Kevin Steen. And he'll always be Kevin Steen to me, not Kevin Owens. I thought they could have put some NXT talent in there. They didn't. I was upset about that. Another thing that was puzzling to me. Bray Wyatt is made to look so strong. He's made to look so powerful. Now, my final four going in was, because I thought Bryan was red hot. And I said, the way he's red hot, I don't think there's any way that they're not going to have him in the final four. The same with Ziggler. I had Roman, Bryan, Ziggler, and Rusev, because you need a heel in there. And I was half right. I mean, Roman and Rusev were the final two, but Ziggler was eliminated, and again, with little fanfare. And Bryan was eliminated way early with little fanfare. Now, maybe this was better off. Because looking back in my mind, if Bryan was the final two with Roman Reigns, and Roman Reigns eliminated Bryan, I think Roman gets booed even more. I think you have people actually rushing the ring if that happens. So in a way, maybe it wasn't the worst thing in the world for Roman that Bryan got eliminated early, but the Philadelphia faithful was not happy. And again, Philly is a great crowd because they're live and energetic, but they're fickle, and they boo anything that they don't get their way. Philadelphia is a bunch of crybabies. So I was not surprised in the least that they were booing Roman Reigns, because Philadelphia is known to be a bunch of losers and crybabies. I mean, hell, they booed Santa Claus at a Philadelphia Eagles game. Come on now. So that was my situation on it. I think Roman was looked upon nationally a little bit better than what he was looked at in Philadelphia. And I don't think that should factor in at all. Big Show and Kane, really? I mean, listen, nobody cares about this fat tank. What is he still doing relevant? I mean, it is just amazing how, I don't know if Big Show has pictures of Vince with a goat or something, but why is Big Show all of a sudden winning matches against people that he shouldn't? I mean, why did he beat Eric Rowan twice? Come on, how can we develop new talent when this fat tank's beating them all? And then he's in a major storyline with Roman Reigns, and then he's in the Final Four at the Royal Rumble? Are you kidding me? Big Show? You guys, a fat tank slug who hasn't been able to move in 10 years. He should have retired in 2007. And Kane? Come on, he's another one. I don't know why Big Show and Kane. Yeah, I get that they're the Authority's big monsters. But come on. Big Show and Kane should not have been in the Final Four. I think that made Roman look... I know what they were looking for. If you have Big Show and Kane there and he eliminates him, he's going to look strong. No. You put Wyatt in there who's red hot, and you put maybe someone else in there and that's younger, and it makes Roman look even better. Come on. I mean, I'm tired of seeing the Big Show. I'm tired of seeing Kane, especially Big Show. I mean, the guy's got to go away. One of the worst performers on the roster. No, the worst. He can't move. I would take the great Khali and Mark Henry at this point in a match with themselves than watch another Big Show match. It's just disgraceful. I thought they did a good job with the surprises. I would have liked to see D-Von, would have liked to see RVD. You're hearing now that they kind of teased Orton and Sheamus just to get people to watch it. Because I know my girlfriend was asking 1,000 times, and she's asked me 1,000 times since the Rumble. When is Randy coming back? When is Randy coming back? Apparently, they had no intention of bringing him back. So I don't know when he's going to come back. It would be safe to assume he's coming back at the Rumble. I mean, at Mania, or before Mania, to be in a Mania match. So who knows? But Roman Reigns was booed this year. He was cheered last year. The thing with WWE fans is that they never want what Vince gives to them. They're defiant little babies. I guarantee you if Dolph Ziggler was getting the push, Dolph gets booed. I guarantee you if Ambrose was getting the push, Ambrose gets booed. WWE always likes the underdog. At least the last couple of years, they like the guy that, you know, is not in the main picture. And then when we put a guy in the main picture that they want, then they boo. I mean, how many pops did Roman Reigns get throughout the whole course of 2014? But he's to be the guy now. And some of that's WWE's fault because, listen, you know, we all knew that Roman was going to be the guy. What WWE has to learn is they got to try and make it a little bit more surprising. I have no problem with Roman being the guy because when Roman burst on the scene, and even last year at the Rumble, I said, give it a year from now. He wins the 2015 Royal Rumble. And he will main event WrestleMania 31. I said that last year. Moments after Royal Rumble 2014. Everyone's like, Roman? Really? Yeah. Look now. He's got the look. And honestly, I enjoy Roman's matches. I don't think he's that terrible on the mic. I've seen worse. Lex Luger, Sid Vicious. You want to look up bad guys on the mic? Look up Lex Luger, look up Sid Vicious. Those are terrible guys on the microphone that can't cut a promo. But listen... You know, you got to look at something where you have Roman Reigns as the guy. And listen, everyone can't stop bitching. Roman Reigns. Deal with it. Just deal with it. So that's my take. Roman Reigns, congrats to him winning the 2015 Royal Rumble. And I think Reigns and Lesnar will be one hell of a fight at WrestleMania. If it's a technical wrestling match you're looking for, you're not going to get that. But if you want to fight for the WWE title at WrestleMania in the main event, you're going to get that with Roman and Brock Lesnar. I'm Chris Serrano. This has been my Royal Rumble recap. Raw recaps and SmackDown recaps coming up later in the week.